brother, you're my, you're not my brother no more. You're more dead, you're worse than a kuffar.
Don't embarrass yourself.
No, because you left Islam, brother.
I love this chick.
As we say, we come with love and that, as Jesus, he said.
Who's we? Who says that, Mo?
The Islam is love, innit?
No.
Imam Sadiq said, the deen is love and love is the deen.
Is it?
Yeah, so it's all love, yeah.
Where did he say that?
This is in the hadith, in Al-Kafi.
Is it the one that he would love?
No,
did
no,
he
but
love
listen,
this,
listen,
the deen? Are you today, all about the love, bro?
Listen, today we're sad. Today we're sad because it's the 40th day when Imam Hussein was killed, and Imam Hussein is mentioned in the Bible, the biggest sacrifice to
where?
God.
Hang on a minute, run that by. Did you say you're gonna go like slow with no tequila?
Yeah.
So show me where it's in the Bible.
So I'm wearing black today, all black, as you can
in
see.
In honor of me.
Yeah, black. Yeah, for Imam Hussein. Yeah. Big thing going on out there. You can see the whole world.
Yeah, big things like one. And yeah, which are deep? Like where in the Bible does it say Hussein?
God's biggest sacrifice in the Bible will be in the Euphrates. That's why Abraham, when he was about to sacrifice his son Ishmael with the knife, God said you have to sacrifice.
He didn't ever try and do Ishmael with a knife.
Let me explain.
But you're fibbing on my Bible.
No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, so Abraham saw a dream to sacrifice his son for God.
Yeah, his son, but not Ishmael.
So when he went to sacrifice him, God put the sheep instead
the ram.
Of the ram.
In the bush?
In the thing. So he chopped off the sheep instead. So in the Quran it says, وَفَدَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ. What does that mean? We have compensated him with a bigger sacrifice, which was Imam Hussein, who's the cousin of Jesus.
Where's that?
Who's the
don't talk crap! I can't take it today.
Jeremiah.
Yeah, give me it. Let me see. Don't panic. He's going to put it on the
screen. Jeremiah 46.
Give me the tip, bro. Wait. Sorry. Oh, Jerome says, let me.
You know about this brother, you know.
I commend your passion. And yes, I got the mics, so let me speak. That's all right, babe. Right, so it says, wow, that's little writing. It says, fudge. All right, give me two. Make it bigger for me. I'm
wait,
old.
1 second, yeah. I can't really
read it.
I can't dab you reading my Bible, bro.
Listen.
It says there are numerous peoples relayed from the Holy Prophet about the martyrdom of Imam Hussein. That's not the Bible, bro. I need the Bible, bro. I am hanging, bro.
For this is the day of the Lord God of hosts, a day of vengeance that he may avenge him of adversaries.
Adversaries,
and the sword shall devour, and it shall be satiated and made drunk with their blood. For the Lord God of hosts has a sacrifice in the Lord's country by the river Euphrates. The land of Karbala is situated next to Euphrates.
Wicked. Where does it say Hussein?
Yeah, who was sacrificed there? Imam Hussein, the biggest sacrifice. Adam cried for Hussein. Abraham cried for Hussein. You know Noah's Ark, 150,000 nails from heaven were given back to Noah.
Did you not promise me you're not going to talk crap?
No, what? Come on, Kane, man.
Come on, bruv.
You're not like the reborn Christians who are very nice and calm. You know,
I'm going to bang you out about not like the reason. Listen, mate, I'm not in the mood.
Chapter 17, verse 20, doesn't God say that he's going to make Ishmael a father of 12 kings? There was only four Arab prophets.
Bring me the verse.
If I bring it, will you accept that revelation?
This brother's...
No, I'm not going to accept none of your twaddle.
Okay,
if you just bring me the Bible, please.
1 minute.
And I'll give you an exegesis. Because you are supposed to check the scripture with me.
1 minute. And as for Ishmael, I have heard you. Behold, I have blessed him and will make him fruitful and will multiply him exceedingly. 12 princes shall he beget and I will make him a
now
great
now tell
nation.
Me the part. Yeah, excellent. Excellent. Great does not make... Wait. Exactly. Now reread to
who
me.
Wait,
bro, do you hear me speaking? Do you see my mouth moving? Show me the bit that tells me about Ishmael being a wild donkey of a man and his hand against
Allah. This is a lie
this is
about Bible. Yeah, this is
you're
a lie.
Telling me Yahweh's lying.
No, this ain't the day for you, bro,
and I'm not the chick for you to start this crap with me today.
It's not me. Would you like if you're calling a prophet of God?
I'm telling you that my Bible is infallible.
That's right.
It doesn't matter what Dean says.
So why does Jehovah's Witness say there's 50,000 mistakes?
Because they've got a stupid, an incorrect Bible.
Why does the reborn Christians who are Protestant say that you lot are on Bath and you lot are
born again?
Born again, sir. Yeah.
Why are you making up a lingo as you go along?
You're not like Ismail. You don't don't like Ishmael.
It's nothing to do with I don't like. There's no prophets coming from Ishmael.
The Bible curses a lot of the prophets. They curse, it does violence.
It's not cursing, it's telling the truth.
Okay, it says it will make Ishmael.
Well, you think David should have been given props from the beginning?
Okay, 1 minute. Ishmael was an Arab. He's the father of the Arabs.
Yes.
Ishmael.
Okay. And God himself equates Arabs with wanton hussies.
How many Arab prophets?
Because you prostitute yourself to false gods.
No.
Oh, yes, he does.
How many Arab prophets were there?
None. Zero.
No. Can I just say something? Allah sent 124,000 prophets. The main prophets. One second. The main prophets were Noah, who lived for 1,000 years.
There's 50 in the Bible. No, show me the other 123,000.
Noah, Moses, Jesus, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alayhi. But I just want to say something. Noah's Ark. You know Noah's Ark. They even found they found the pins for Noah's Ark, and it was written Muhammad, Ali, Fatima, Hassan, Hussein. And they check it on YouTube. And Noah, the angel Gabriel gave him 150,000 nails
from
heaven.
Show me this thing. Show me this.
So how did he build the ark? Where did he get the nails from? Angel Gabriel helped Noah build the ark.
What's that God do with a person fish?
I'm gonna explain. Yeah. One second, Habibi, one second.
Habibi.
People are saying, oh, Eve is born from the rib of Adam, which is not true. Eve was...
What?
She
it's not true.
No, let me explain.
You're calling Yahweh a liar.
No, we're not.
Yes, you are.
Do you know who's...
You're going to blaspheme the spirit in a minute, and I'm going to get, like, upset for you.
He wasn't born from his rib. When Allah created...
She. It's called she in English.
When Allah created Adam, the bit that was left, he created her from that.
Oh, crap!
Wait, one second, let me explain. And then Adam, alayhi salam, the father of all prophets, remember, let me just explain. Jesus, alayhi salam, Jesus, you know Jesus that has come
out? I do know Jesus, you don't.
Okay.
Say the arrogance, just show me the truth of it.
Slowly. Okay.
Slowly, what, like catching
I'm monkey? Not, I swear to God, I'm not arguing with you because I've got love for you, the funniest girl I've ever seen, but listen, yeah? Please, yeah? The prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they all came with one message to worship Allah, right? To worship one God. Okay? Let me say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. All the prophets of Allah, all of them
cried. Oh, yeah, the prophets of Allah, there's only one in it.
124,000. Yeah. All of them cried for Imam Hussein.
Show me, where's the Eskimo prophet?
You know
of
when
Allah?
Jesus passed Karbala?
Where's the Japanese prophet of Allah? Jesus. What happened to their book?
I'm going to say.
No, you're not. You're going to talk crap.
All these 124,000 prophets.
Where are they? From where's the evidence? Muhammad is the last one.
Yeah, the main of these 124,000, 300 of them are the main messengers, like the main top ones. Yeah, 300 out of the 124,000.
Yep.
The ones, like for example, Nuh alayhi salam, when he was 10 generations from Adam. So Adam, and then it was 10 generations, then it was Noah, alright? So this is what I've read, yeah? So Adam and Eve, they had a daughter and son, they got married. And then their children, it was haram for them to get married, so they could marry their cousins. After that, Allah made the rule, no brother can marry their sister. After Adam and Eve's children got married, the two.
I want to talk about Jesus now, because I'm not a student of Sodom. No, you can't. Thanks for asking. So Jesus came. I don't know, judgment day. So Jesus came in order that lost souls who may be clinging to some traditions of men, who may be listening to people because they're related to someone else who is rejected by Christianity anyway. Like, he came for basically people like this. People keep saying to me, quite frankly, no offense, man, they say, why do you talk to him? Okay, because he ain't hearing it. And I know that people on the, like, there's many people who watch the videos because we do have a laugh, like, it's funny. But in all seriousness, on Judgment Day, every knee is going to bow and every tongue is going to confess that Christ is Lord. And it ain't no fake counterfeit Christ. It's not Isa. Isa did not die for anybody, and therefore he cannot be my Jesus. And anyone who comes with a false Jesus or a false gospel or a book other than this, like a Jesus other than this, a gospel other than this, is accursed. Even if an angel of the light is the one bringing the news. And Jibril, I just want to throw it out there, was an angel. So it's already foretold and it's taking you to hell. Don't do it.
There's 450 English versions of the Bible, yeah?
Excellent.
All translating, you doing...
All one iteration, don't forget that.
Thousands of manuscripts disagreeing with each other from your own books, widely in vice versa, actually teach entirely different things.
Different translations do not teach anything. Translations are just an iteration, one iteration from the Greek or the Hebrew. A translation does not teach, a translation informs you of that translation of the original. The teaching comes from human beings.
Okay, listen, yeah? There's a lot of mistakes here, geographical mistakes, historical mistakes in the Bible. I just want to say, listen, I've got love for you, but listen, the people that killed Imam Hussein are the worst people in the world. Imam Hussein is Jesus.
I thought Christians and Jews were the worst of all creatures.
No, the people that killed Imam Hussein.
Well, you're
were
changing
the worst.
It now. The Quran says what it doesn't. The Quran doesn't say the worst of all people are the people who killed Hussein.
It says the munafiqin fil dark.
Was it Jews and Christians?
Allah says in the Quran. No, it was Yazid. His army.
Yazid is a god. Like
Yazid was Muawiyah's son. Yeah, Hind's grandson. Yeah, Abu Sufyan's grandson. Look. What I'm trying to say is that the hypocrites will be in the lowest the depth of hell.
Anyone without the blood of Jesus will be in hell. Do
you know what Jesus said?
I know what Jesus said.
Jesus passed Karbala in Iraq and he started crying. And
he never went. What are you talking about?
He passed it.
What, on a donkey flying over?
Jesus was walking around a lot of places.
Walking around? You
Jesus
loon.
Comes from that region though. You
it's not that region. On foot. What are you telling me? You just strolled up to Scotland. Come off it, bro. What are you talking about,
No, Jesus was white. No, he was white.
Why are you bringing that sort of crap? Please, come up your game,
Jesus
mate.
Was white with red...
No, I'm not even chatting that. His blood was red. Perfect.
Yeah,
that's
he had
what
red
matters.
He had red cheeks. No,
it's not about that, though. It doesn't matter. He said there's neither Jew nor Gentile in Christ. There's no distinction of different, races.
What I'm trying to say, when Abraham got thrown into the fire and the fire became cold for Abraham...
When
Nimrod tried to kill him.
Okay.
Yeah. What I'm trying to say, there was miracles. So Abraham came with miracles.
Everyone, you heard it first.
Moses' stick got so big it was going to eat Pharaoh. Pharaoh himself.
And he what himself?
He himself. Pharaoh, because he saw Moses' snake was massive.
Also, Moses did not have a scrotal hernia.
Nah.
I'm just throwing it out.
Nah, do you know why Moses had a list? Because he ate the coal.
No, I'm not talking about his list. I'm talking about his testicles. There's some hadith that says that the rock was.
Is that in Bukhari? That's all lies, man.
You say
that. Bukhari says
many Muslims.
Bukhari says a lot of lies.
They might say that Kafi and.
No. But we'll never disrespect the prophets in Kafi.
Come, bro.
What I'm trying to say.
Khalas.
The books like Bukhari, they disrespect the Prophet Muhammad. They disrespect the Prophet Moses.
But we're talking about Jesus.
We don't accept these books.
Okay, I don't accept none of your
Anyone who disrespects a prophet gets violated, gets on-site.
Violated? What kind of roadman chat is that?
You can't disrespect the Prophet of God. That's why people think it's a joke. Like, it's not a joke. But what I'm trying to say...
I think you're a joker.
No, listen to what I'm saying. Listen to what I'm saying. I'll blame Shaitan Ajim. So Moses...
Really.
So when Moses done a miracle... Like that, even Pharaoh didn't believe. So the snake got...
Even Pharaoh, the one who Yahweh hardened his heart,
the snake became as tall as Twin Towers. I swear. Why do you think the magicians believed? It went massive. I swear, Moses...
Massive, bro.
Yeah, every prophet came from Moses. Moses, yeah. So what I'm saying, Noah told his son...
What miracle did Adam do in your book?
Okay, all right, this is what happened.
Because he's not a prophet for us.
That makes sense. Adam, basically, yeah, Adam is the father of prophets.
But he's not a prophet. He's the father of non-prophets as well. He's the father of everyone.
Everyone. What I'm trying to say is that, for example, Noah, his son was bad. Do you understand? Prophet Noah.
Which son?
His son. He's got one of his sons.
He's got three sons. Shem, Ham, and Japheth.
One of them said, I'll go on the mountain. Noah's wife is in hell. Lot's wife, Prophet Lot, his wife is going to be in hell. So it doesn't mean just because you're married to a prophet that you're saved.
Because Christians don't have that sort of crap.
That's why there's a lot of
Except actually the household of a believer in the Bible was saved by his faith. So yeah, actually, I'll go along with that. But Lot and his wife, there's pillars of salt involved, there's disobedience to God right to his face. God goes, don't look round, and they go, you're what now? And they're looking back, and that's that bit. And already they're not perfect people. The whole point of prophethood and prophecy is to bring other people to the truth. It doesn't mean that you are blessed with a perfect existence. Because if you were, you wouldn't need any help. Lot sinned. Moses
No, no prophet sinned.
Yes, they did. Oh, David was big in the sin game. I don't follow them. What do you mean?
Alright. No,
I follow Jesus.
I want to ask you, John, chapter of the Bible.
Is this relevant to what we're
This is just a question about
the
Bible.
If you already brought up the white Jesus, I feel like you're
Christian
reaching.
I just want to ask you something. Yes.
Yeah.
1 second, yeah. I want to ask you, do you believe God is the greatest, yeah? God is the greatest.
God is good. Yeah.
What's your view on, obviously you believe in the Holy Trinity and stuff,
yes.
Yeah? What is that? The Father?
It's the Godhead. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
The Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Okay, basically, so you believe Jesus is God?
Yes.
Okay.
I don't believe that Jesus is the entirety of the Godhead. I believe he is one person of the Godhead.
Okay.
He is fully and rightfully God in his own right, but he is not the Holy Spirit and he is not the Father.
Okay, no one is greater than God.
Yes.
Okay, John, chapter 14, verse 28. Yeah. He says that the Father is greater than I.
Yes, so that's not saying... Hang on, let me answer you then, because you've got a slight linguistic error of thinking.
Yeah, okay.
God is both Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Jesus is not saying there is anything, he's not, like, he's talking about within the Godhead, he's not talking, there's nothing greater than God, he's not saying that.
So the Godhead, so you believe this, God is like in three different parts?
No, not three different parts, three distinct persons, within, of the same essence, the same authority, the same divinity, the same gloriousness. Like,
so Jesus and God are together.
When you say God, if you just reiterate, if you're talking about the Father, you're not talking about, because the triune God, there is no Jesus outside of the triune God. The triune God has Jesus, has the word in there. The Son is in that triunity. So when the Bible sometimes is translated as God said to the Son, it's the Father is speaking to the Son, because there is no triune God and another one. When Jesus was on earth, yes.
That's what he says.
And that's what I just agreed with. Yeah, he was on earth at the time.
Right, so these are three heads of God, but some of them are greater than others.
When Jesus is a man, he is admitting rightfully that the Father is greater. The Father, he doesn't have the Father working through him as such. He sees what the Father does and he does it. He equals greatness in terms of what he's performing, and his knowledge is almost equal to that of the Father. But you have to remember that he's encased in the shell of humanity at that time. Yeah, when he is the divine word, he is God. He is with God and he is God, and there is no distinction. He is co-equal, co-authority, co-divinity. Everything is equal. Yeah, I go with flying donkeys when I think of far-fetched.
So I get what you're saying, but just from an outsider's perspective.
I understand, yeah. The Bible says that you're unable to grasp it.
Events that happened 2,000 years ago.
Sorry, I don't know if anyone can hear. The guy's telling... Oh, shucks, where's my other... Oh, yeah. The guy is saying to me, am I aware that it may sound far-fetched to people who don't, believe that, and I'm agreeing.
Jesus is God, and then he says the Father is greater than I.
Yeah,
I
mean, the Father is in God. And
yeah,
Jesus
it's all a bit messy.
It's not messy, bro. I'll tell you what's messy. One shin and two right arms. That's a bit messy.
Yeah, that's Wahhabis believe.
Who talks about that?
That's Wahhabis.
Listen, it's all good if you want to distinguish yourself from other kinds of Muslims. But Islam is one, I keep being told.
Allah, he has no beginning, no end.
Yeah, but he's got a shin. There's a Muslim ruling. Excuse me. There is a Muslim. Anyway, I'll take my own camera. There's a Muslim ruling. There's a Muslim. Yeah, I heard you, bro, the 17th time. Salafis, Wahhabis. The point is that there is a ruling within one school of Sharia, at least, that the attributes, the physical attributes of God, are to be taken literally. I can find the reference. Sorry, it'll go on the screen.
Sharia is a bit far-fetched.
I'd say it's an absolute atrocity.
Yeah, it's an atrocity.
Yeah.
You'd agree with me there.
I would. Are you Muslim?
No, I'm not Muslim.
That helps.
You've got this healthy skepticism, right, when it comes to Islam, right?
I've got an outright distrust of it, because you've got
it sounds to me like you've got a healthy skepticism when it comes to Islam, right?
I like my salvation.
You want to be skeptical on the whole, right?
Yeah.
On the whole, and so there's some grounding or evidence to believe in, right?
I'll never believe it.
No, I'm saying in principle.
If there was evidence in principle, my face, I would rebuke Satan.
Yeah, okay. But why don't you apply the same sort of
skepticism to Christianity? I literally study theology. I'm not just a surface level.
Yeah, I know,
like,
but
oh, that sounds
if you study theology, then you'd know more. You'd understand the historicity of the Bible.
I do.
Right?
Yes.
That the Bible was written in multiple eras.
Yes.
That
attests to its glory.
The Bible basically consists of what, 27 books?
No, 66 or 73.
Sorry. Just the New Testament would consist of 27.
39. 30, yeah.
Yeah. So essentially, we're talking about a collection of books that come together.
We are.
Through natural, sort of socio-economic, political reasons.
No,
history.
No, I diverge from you there. No, I don't believe that's the reason.
I think that's the reasonable.
You think that's the reasonable. I'm saying you think that is the impetus for the collection of those books.
Yeah, I think society.
And you don't include in that salvation or God's communication with mankind.
No,
I don't believe that the early church fathers. But you thought they were sitting around going, do you know what? Socio-politically and economically, I reckon we need a little library.
I don't think exactly.
So I'm saying what they believed.
Like
they exactly because they weren't Cockney. But the point is, they were trying to bring the revelation of God to be compounded into one book.
I see what you're saying, but if you're going to...
So there were considerations of socioeconomic, like Jesus had those same considerations.
Let's look at what the Muslims say, right? The Muslims say, just a second, just look, as a point of reference, I think it's useful, right? The Muslims will say... Prophet Muhammad.
He's my friend. He went
to a cave at some point.
Hira.
Yeah, he went. Good one. At one point in time, he went to meditate in a cave, right? While he was in the cave, he saw
some demon. He thought it was a demon. Let's not go off the real story.
No,
he thought it was the demon because he ran to Khadija and to Warraka.
As a theologian,
he thought it was a demon.
Just a second.
He later learned Warraka told him.
Bakari, that's a liar. Is a liar.
The story is what the story is, right?
Yeah,
okay, yeah. Whether he thought it was a demon or whatever it was.
I didn't think it was no one. I went there.
But the point is, he went back to the people and he said to them.
No, he went to his wife and he hid under her clothing. So just mind out the way.
Sorry, sorry. To the wife, right? And he said to the wife,
he said, hide me under your skirts, double check for me if this is an angel, because I'm feeling a bit demonized.
What I'm going to do is I'm going to summarize just because I want to make a point, basically, right?
Amen.
So,
So
he claimed that he saw Gabriel. Nobody else saw Gabriel.
He was on his jacks,
right? Yeah. He was on his own, right? So in principle, he's beholden to the idea that he's a prophet, but I don't have.
He kept trying to step up the mountains, and Jibs would turn up and go, no, you are a prophet. He didn't believe it himself.
So the point is, the story, there's just no evidence for it, right?
Amen.
It's a story.
Jesus is historically attested to.
He was just another guy. He was just another Jew.
You think the Roman Empire came down on just the Jew?
No.
You think the Sanhedrin were worried about just the Jew?
Oh, he was just a no one.
He was lowly.
Wait a second. He was crucified with a bunch of thieves, right?
Amen.
And it was a non-event when it happened.
You are so deluded. It's embarrassing.
No,
okay, well, I'll tell you. I'm going to tell everyone else.
What's the evidence?
Allow me to speak.
Please.
So I'm going to just have to counter like quite a... Oh, mate. So the non-eventness of the crucifixion is like blasphemous, basically. But this guy is not a believer, so like that's not on him. But it is... I think you're still speaking, but I'm trying to. It is the most significant event in the whole of mankind, alongside the miraculous birth and the resurrection. So as a package deal, that's the three things that are utterly attested to by the Holy Spirit who dwells inside you, and by historicity. There were playwrights at the time who were non-Christians. There was Flavius Josephus who recorded that Christ was, doing all the... I'll put that up on the screen as well. So those things happened, and they are attested to outside of Christian writings. So there's no reason for non-Christians to get involved at this point and back up the story. Also, like the Pontius Pilate and all of that, there are further writings of their conversations about it.
It was a question of why did you kill this man of God, basically. So, a little. Hi, I just said I studied theology. Of course I've read him, but he's not like my go-to guy because he's an atheist. Yes. Literally at the time of Jesus, like as it was like. But let me just ask why, because I'm supposed to.
Can I ask physically, what's the evidence? Where is it written?
I'll give you one thing. I think this is a bit of a long, detailed answer you're waiting for. No, I know it is because I've got it. This one it is. Yes. You're not even getting to the end of your question. I'm waiting for Mo to check because I've got.
I'll make a point on the end. I can leave it.
No, I'm trying to answer you, but what you're doing is you're bulldozing me. No, he's not.
No way. You left this long.
No way.
He's your mate, mate.
He's my friend. His brother's my friend. His dad's my friend.
You helped him out.
No, you're joking. I thought you were joking when you said you're not
Muslim. He watched you with your lifestyle when he went like, nah.
You're not Muslim no more. You left this long.
Well, you see her. He's back in second place.
I thought he was doing that.
See this, Mo thought he was BSing me and he's standing
there.
Yeah,
he said it was true.
But he might be Takiri and you.
Are you Takiri last night?
What lesson did you learn?
It's going on today, man. Hey, nah, you're serious. Say wallahi.
Say wallahi. It doesn't matter if he says wallahi. He don't believe the wallahi.
Bro, the...
Bro,
you know we're going to have to... After this, we're going to have to take you around the corner.
And kill you for apostasy. Yeah. You muppet.
Just, you know...
Everyone knows.
Hey, listen.
Right, so tell me your team.
You after, we'll deal with you after.
You ain't dealing with no one, mate, because I'm a witness.
You what?
You're dealing with witnesses.
Hey, listen. Basically, Jesus, he came to the...
Where's your sauces? Show me
Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq. Coffee.
Two sugars, please.
Verily, the Jesus, son of Mary, came to the tomb of the son of Zachariah. And he asked his Lord, he asked Allah to bring him back to life. Then he called him and answered him. And he came out from the grave and he said to him, what do you want from me, Jesus? And then Jesus said to him, I want you to be friends with me as you were in this world. Then he said to Jesus, oh Jesus, the heat of death has not subsidized, has not gone from me, and you want me to return to this world, and the heat of death will return to me again. So Jesus left him and he returned to his grave. Yeah, I just wanted to say, and this, you lot, just get ready for the grave, because when the two angels, Munkar and Nakir, who are the
first name basis,
their head is in the seventh sky, and their stick is in the seventh sky.
Their stick is bigger than the Twin Towers.
Their fangs are massive, and their eyes are like lightning.
Bro, how many faces they got?
They're going to ask you, how many faces? They're very scary. If you see them,
how many faces they got?
Imam Sadiq said, if you see them, and I forget your name.
How many faces?
One face.
So they're not biblical angels.
Munkar and Nakir. And they're going to say to him, they're going to say to you, who's your Lord? You're going to say, if you don't say Allah, and your prophet is Muhammad, and your imam is Ali,
Now let me speak. All the demons in hell can rise up round about now. They can try and excuse me, do I look like I'm finished, Lopan? They can try to get me to confess Allah as no, it ain't happening, because Jesus is Lord. He is King of Kings. There ain't no mootah ting here, bro. So the point is that Jesus alone is worthy on earth of this. Listen, he's going
to
judge you, Mo. You better
run. You're about to get ended, bro.
Over the camera. Well,
enjoy their last seconds, mate. I just wanted to say,
everybody, there's a timestamp. If this gentleman ever goes missing in the near future, my man here has just confessed live on my phone.
No, there's no, now he's considering it.
No comment, Your Honor.
Listen, you're my op now. Yeah, listen. But listen to this.
Lucky's got a side to go with the op.
In the fiqh, Imam Sadiq says, if a Christian or a non-Muslim became Muslim and then he reverted back to another religion, in Islam, it's not death penalty for him, but it's only a person.
Why is it?
Yeah, it's not, because he's not born Muslim.
Make out you as a Jew. But no, he was laughing.
But if you're born Muslim like this guy, and then
he was born Muslim.
And
Allah guides him. I got the mics. Allah guides.
Big brr.
You know you're going to be in the rap video. Anyway, Allah guides who he guides, and he misguides who he misguides. And he says to the Muslims, not you, sir, he says, don't try and guide who I'm misguiding.
Exactly.
And then he probably added, like, your mug. But the point is, he's been misguiding.
This guy's a kafir.
Allah told you.
He's a kafir.
Allah. You remember Allah. The one kid, the two hands.
Inna Allah la'ana al-kafirin wa a'adda lahum
sa'ira. He goes against his own stuff.
You're mushrik.
I'm the only kafir in the village. I am kafir.
Brother, you're mushrik. No, you're not my brother no more. You're Murtad, you're worse than a kafir.
Don't embarrass yourself.
No, because you left Islam, brother. You're not brother, it's no brother.
I thought you loved everyone.
No, I love the good people. I love Jesus.
I'm a kafir.
No, I love you. You're not a kafir, man. You're the people of the book.
You get behind me, Moses.
Hey, listen. Right. We can marry the people of the book.
You ain't no good.
According to the Shia, we can only marry the people of the book with Mut'ah, but Muslim marriage and family marriage. That's according to the
fiqh of Ayatollah Sistani. I think I'll just bow out now then.
No, you can marry the people of the book.
You can't marry me!
With Mut'ah.
You can't?
I can't marry you permanent marriage.
You can't marry unless me you one your time, shahada. Two times, your 25 minutes. Jesus is Lord.
Jesus, the Jesus.
Listen, right, this is all coming out. Jesus is Lord. I know you never said this.
He's going to get. Hey, bruv, it's not.
He offered me the love of Jesus.
I might be nice and kind with you lot, but the people that are Murtad, that leave Islam and they're born Muslim, I'm not joking with them, but it's on site. What?
Okay, Mo, it's enough of the Mo D.
Trisha, I know your brother, I know your dad.
You are over 16,
and I know you. I know you from when we were young.
Are you liable for criminal
conviction? When we used to go Chelsea, we used to go primary school in Chelsea.
Threats to kill are a crime.
You left this stump, but you're a pagan right now. But you're a pagan.
Come off my camera with your nonsense. Hey, waste man.
But you're a pagan. I've got love for your brother. I've got love for your dad. I know you when you were young and we used to go to primary school in Chelsea.
Jason!
You're my brethren, bro. But I love for the sake of Allah and I hate for the sake of Allah.
Wrap up. Thank you. Come with me.
What?
Come away. Bro, what? Get out of my space. Stop making me swear because he's going to have to beep it and it takes time. Listen, bro, you promised me.
I'm on this case. I'm not on you.
Laters then. Go take my man over there. How embarrassing. Yeah, I'm all right. He's a muppet. Listen, he's on something. Other words. Oh, this is. Anyway, the wrap up is Mo is running about like some sort of road man on camera. I feel for this man in terms of like he needs salvation. He needs the Holy Spirit like lively. Pronto tonto is what we're saying. He needs his meds, he needs a slap, he needs to stop propositioning Christian women, he needs all sorts of things.
You're mad, is he crazy?
Listen, I've got my own back, bro, I've got my front back sideways. Let me wrap up this video and I'm coming to you. So the Malumba says, hey mate, I'm in an open air asylum. And this is why I'm so grateful for your prayers, for your support of SoCo. Like my own channel, Bob's channel. Anyone who's doing God's work here, like, please remember us in your prayers. Like, no joke. I got a couple of people in my life, like, you know, in my channel who are like on it. They're like a little prayer squad. And I'm just so grateful. I can't even, like, embarrass them by saying their names or anything because, like, I take the power out of the sacrifice of their time because I appreciate people's time because my time is, like, kind of important to me. And yeah, by giving my time, like I'm showing my love. And when I get some Islamophobia, which is on a regular, like it's not the case. Because if I didn't love Muslims, or more so if I didn't love Jesus, I wouldn't be down here dealing with this crap the way I feel today. I wouldn't be down, I'd just be, you know, getting on with my life, as it were. But this is my life because, like I have a life now because of Jesus. And that is a wrap because Mo is coming back and I can't take this. Mo, please don't test me, mate. Take your finger out my face before I go rogue on you. Let me just wrap this up and I'm coming to you, mate. Anyway, oh, serenity. Holy Spirit. Right, God bless you all. If you're a Christian, stay that way. If you're not, if you're thinking about it, know that this is not all we have to do. Like, just come into my comment section and I'm happy, happy, happy to answer real life questions without no copy paste nonsense. All right, lots of love to you people. Lots of love to you people. Obviously, lots of love that way because, oh, he's gone. Right, I'll see you later, Anna. Bye bye.